family parents are typical like strict family, so they don't want me to do the music, but they forced me to become a police officer, and they forced me to go to Jeonje, but I wasn't interested in that. So long story short, and I had a passion, vision with the song, and I was just creating a song when I was 20. Now I'm 37. And then, just make a song with friends and try to bring my demo to American label. And no one accepted me because, I don't know, maybe I'm Asian or whatever. They kind of like looked down on me back in the day. So I was like, you know what? I'm Korean, so let me bring my song to Korea, try to give a shot. And I just went to over 50 labels, and I was like, you know what, I'm my name's Ryan, and I'm from New York. I'm a producer of my song in ABCDE, but since I have a heavy accent, and also I have an accent with in Korean too, and I'm from southern part of Korea, like Busan, right? So they're just questioning about me. Right, this guy is from New York, but he has like he speaks broken English, and he has a heavy accent, and no one trusts me. At that time, I had a Lucifer demo with my friend, so I was just, you know, give out the song to every different label, and no one really liked it. And actually, I had that record with Neverland too when I had a demo. So SM was the first one who was interested in our song, and they took the track and they tried to fix a little more of stuff here there, which is one of the main producer from SM Entertainment, Yu Young Jin, and he just finalized all the song for me, and that's how I get connected with SM. So SM just took me out here. He wants to see that this guy is true or not. And that's how I started. And also, Neverland was, since same producer, same writer, we've been writing together, so we had a similarity with the song, but the Lucifer was my official debut in Korea.